aggressive and drunk. And now when Cornell Whitfield went back to Dubai, he ended up getting jailed for a year for this. And so the man wanted $60,000 to drop the allegation. Can you imagine? So it's like extortion, really. Mm-hmm. And so he was arrested in August and he was sentenced to a year in jail. So now, you know, his lawyer, Rhoda Sterling, is saying if a bodyguard can be jailed for protecting his client, should celebrities really be supporting Dubai? Foreigners are seen as prey by locals who know they will pay large sums of money to have frivolous or false cases dropped. Locals have turned Dubai's police force into an extortion tool, making it extremely risky for tourists. And something like that would make me be like, I don't feel as comfortable going there.
The laws in Dubai are definitely very different than here.
Yeah.
They'll lock you up quick.
For a year for that? All right, well, anyway, we're praying that he gets home safely and that bringing attention to this case will actually help him get home. All right, well, that is your Under the Radar. We do have the Way It Mix coming at the top of the hour, so let's party getting ready for a Friday because it is Thursday right now. Also, Mariah the Scientist is going to be joining us. She has a new project that is dropping tomorrow, and this is our first sit-down, so I'm excited. It's Way Up with Angela Yee, Mariah the Scientist, coming up later. Going way...
Hey, try...
On the court this morning, guess who can travel out of Cincinnati?
Yeah, shout out my boy B.
Yes, sir. You know what I've got to do when I'm on the radio?
What?
I said, shout out my boy Pat.
Smell me?
Phone for $2. Tell you how much Android worth.
Hello? gotta make the money first.
Smell me!
Then when you get the money,
hey! Y'all know what the fuck going on.
Then
when
you get the power, then you get the woman.
Yeah.
That's why you gotta make your own.
That's why I get them. Nah. Got you. Power.
The money got me though.
Take off in this motherfucker. G5, let's go!
G5, S-Class, big dog, big bag. Run up on me and get shit bag. Right now, quick fast, sink ship, quick sand.
Fellas, it get, I'm the illest. Check out the chill on my wrist, I'm rich as a bitch. DVVS is cost a big and a fish. Flippin' it, Chris, little bitty bitch. You get crossed off the list, be in the game. BB Lee, 1-3-6, Mafia.
It's clean.
What's up?
Welcome.
Sheena
Ferrari kept the one
that
he's pushing under UMG.
All right.
I'm about to go grab Chris real quick.
This your camera deal right here?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'm about to give you some heat, bro.
Sorry. Wow,
I'm right back. I'm going to go grab my kitty real quick.
Network. What's your name?
Ryan.
Ryan. All right.
Sir.
Pat.
Tropicana, where you want Pac to sit?
Sonno. Nice to meet you, bro. Nice to meet you, bro. What's your name?
Right here.
Right. Nice to meet you.
We in the building. 101.1 The Wiz. Smell me? No cap. Hey, Gucci.
You got a hat on here?
I'm a straight shooter. How you doing, brother?
Good to see you, bro.
Good to see you, too.
How's everybody doing?
Hey, how you doing?
Oh, he in Columbus, too? What's the sister station in Columbus?
Our sister station is Power 107.5,
106.3.
Okay. Glad we met you, because we were getting
you. Hey, can we take a picture real quick?
Let's do it.
Coaching the family too.
What? Yeah. We gonna definitely talk about that. Hilltop, let's go.
Hey, y'all, cause I gotta tell y'all.
You gotta talk about
Hilltop. He play for Hilltop, but he don't play for Hilltop.
Well, that
my baby, he was little. So his first season, and I can't. He'll tell it himself. He's seven now. Y'all, his first game, Pac-Man, he saw the other kid. The other kid was much bigger than him. So
probably
Boogie, like, see him coming? He said, hell nah, and just laid down on the field like Jesus.
And y'all realize he ain't the first one that's gonna do that, but when it kick in,
it's gonna kick in.
I got 4 and 5 years.
He's so hungry to do it now, but I'm scared to put you back in after you done went on the cross for him.
You
gotta
need that one good hand.
And man, to get him up, though.
Bro, Junie at 4, he wouldn't even go in the game.
Yeah.
And if you see him right now, you be like, ain't no way this the same kid last year that wouldn't go in the game.
He just scared to hit. He'll tell you, and they'll be knocking him down. He'll be like, they running right through me like a ghost, mama. Like, he'll get out of it.
If he can talk about it like that, he'll get out of it.
Put him back in?
Yeah.
Because he swear he gang, because it's a gang.
He's
top, so.
It is.
Every day with it. That's dope.
Yeah.
We'll talk about all that on air. I'll be making the city mad because I only talk about Hilltop when So when they call,
we got playoffs this week too.
And it's going down. We'll talk about all of that. I'm going to delete some songs too, and we just gonna jump in and out.
Yeah. We ain't on no time limit. I'm chilling.
Yeah.
However long you want me, or when I gotta get off here.
Pac-Man is in the building. What's happening? 101.1 Wiz. How you doing today?
Man, I'm doing good. Everything's happening in the community. They just tore down the Boys and Girl Club downtown. I'm trying to figure out what happened with that.
Because where the kids gonna go?
That's what I'm saying. Like, I'm all about making stuff better and building, but the kids are the future. We got a lot of unnecessary violence.
Yes.
And I just truly feel like if you don't have nowhere to have an outlet or have somewhere to go, you're stuck in the same spot at all time. You know what the repercussion of that gonna be. So
I feel like they took a lot of resources away from our community for our kids. Yeah. We used to have Rex Center on every corner where you can go get your homework done. We still got them, but they don't really have the funding that they used to have. You
yeah, but
got no teen parties, nowhere for kids that's safe to go kick it.
I think we close. I'm definitely working with a lot of people. If anybody know me, we always giving back as a group. We got a 5 youth team at Hilltop, the Savage Boys. You smell me? Yeah.
What's up, Lil Boogie?
Yeah, shout out to the whole Hilltop organization. And not just only Hilltop, all the other youth football leagues and everything else. But, like, I'm trying to partner with people who are really trying to do right for the community. Yeah. That's all the way 100% honest, and I think I'm right there. I think I'm almost there. We got a lot of things going for the community. As you already know, we give our bikes every Christmas. We always doing back to school drives. We got a thing for the homeless on the 11th here where we're giving coats and food. Our foundation is Hello World. So I'm all for the community.
November
of course,
11?
November 12th. Sorry, November 12th. But this mental health thing is really big with me.
For grown-ups, for kids?
Everybody. Grown-ups, kids. My mom didn't tell me she was bipolar until I was rich. I'm like, how do you not tell me that when I'm growing up and going through all these trials and tribulations?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
That's what I'm for. I'm for the youth, giving back, having an outreach to talk to somebody. It's okay to talk about some. You know, I ain't trying to be soft in that because I talk a lot of, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's balanced.
Yeah.
It's balanced.
Yeah.
And it's crazy that you even mentioned mental health for kids. We got a town hall that we're doing with the Center for Closing the Health Gap. The kids are struggling with their self-esteem. They are struggling with grief.
Yeah.
And they are struggling with depression post-COVID. Social media is making them feel really uncomfortable. So we are going to bring some psychologists together and some therapists to talk about it because that's a real issue our babies are going through.
Yeah, I love that. If I could be any way I could be a part of that, I would love to be a part
of it. Well, say less. The Trap House, your house.
Trap House, you smell me. And look, we got to vote.
Let's talk about
it. We got
to
vote.
Now, you were talking earlier about a special reason why you felt like we needed to make sure we vote. Why is it important that the citizens of Cincinnati, 18 and up, get to the polls?
Because I am a truly believer in mental health first, and I smoke hella weed.
Mm-hmm,
I prefer to smoke weed than take some of the stuff that I'm prescribed. Shout out to King City Garden. We got the biggest growth here in Ohio. We'll be opening up, I think, November 24th.
Okay.
So we'll have that pack in Cincinnati. But yeah, we need to go vote because we got a chance to be recreational here in Cincinnati, and we can't do it if we don't go vote. Anybody can vote, bro. All you got to do is go have an ID, go to the DMV, sign up to vote. It don't matter by your record, so stop letting people tell you that if you got a felony, you can't vote, because that is not true.
Absolutely. Dang. So with that being said, did you just say you opening up a dispensary?
I'm opening up a growth, which is same thing as a dispensary, but you'll be able to get pack out the pack everywhere in Cincinnati, probably in like another month and a half. The grill gummies, the pens, the cookies. I even got ice cream. So shout out to King City Garden.
We doing big things. Chris, make sure we have an ice cream social in the Trap House next week. Chris, we need to have a meeting.
Yeah.
Pac-Man and the ice cream.
We're gonna get it done, but yeah.
On top of working as hard as you are in the community with these kids and obviously in the fields, harvesting, you've been working on some music.
Yeah.
Killer Wells is crazy.
Killer Wells is crazy.
You've been doing music for a while, though.
I have. You know, I did it, but I couldn't really speak. I really couldn't talk about nothing. It was all commercial.
Yeah.
So I decided probably these last 60 days that, hey, man, go ahead and speak your mind.
Hold on. Did you say 60 days?
60 days.
So
everything you guys
60
heard.
60 days that you decided to take this serious?
Yeah. Everything you guys heard, I've done in the last 60 days.
Beats, this is 2 months of work.
Two and a half months of work, I would say.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm a little lost for words on that one. In 2 months, you dropped Killer Wells and you got something else for me.
This is a Ferrari kit.
All right, well, you heard what's going on. You see what's happening. It's the takeover right here inside the Trap House. We talking voting, we talking mental health, and if you have some questions for Pac-Man Jones, you're more than welcome to call us, 749-1011. Can you stick around and can we play?
You smell me? I'm here.
In the meantime, how do they keep up with you on social if they want to send you some questions right now?
Real Pac-Man 24 on Twitter, Instagram, I'm open.
All right, keep that.
My life is a glass house. Holla at me.
Keep it here. You on the Wiz.
Point one, the Wiz has been the source of hip hop and R&B culture in Cincy.
You need a radio show. You got a podcast?
Yeah. It's me and two Muppets. I used to have a radio show. It was a lot of work because I was doing, 4 days a week?